Tell me, what is the t statistic value? T value?
1.12.
Sorry, 1.?
1.2.
Okay, 1.12. That is the t value. Right? This value 1.12. T statistic is 1.12. And the next one. Next information we need to find out, what is it? Critical value. Critical value. We call it as a table value, critical value. So for that critical value, we need the degree of freedom. The formula to find out degree of freedom in two sample independent details. N1 minus N2 plus N2 minus. Seven minus one plus five minus one. Total degree of freedom is 10. Degree of freedom is 10. Now look at t distribution table. T distribution table. Tell me, what is the critical value at 5% for 10 degree of freedom?
2.228.
That is 5%, right?
At 5%. Yes, sir.
That value is from 5%, correct?
Yes, sir.
Also find out what is the critical value at 1% significance level. How much?
3.169.
At 5% it is 2.228, and at 1% 3.169. Now take decision by using or comparing these values. This one is 1.12 and table. The next one is decision, taking decision by comparing the value. So here t statistic is 1.12, and critical value is 2.228 at 5% and 3.169 at 1%. 2.228 at 5% and 3.169 at 1%. So tell me whether we should accept null hypothesis or reject null hypothesis. When compare at both the level, if you compare both these two values, AT's statistic is less than critical value. So what is our decision? What is our
accepting.
Decision? So we should accept
accepting.
Null hypothesis. So decision. So decision. Accept null hypothesis. Accept null hypothesis. So why are we accepting null hypothesis? Because our test statistic value is less than the critical value at both the significance level. Like if you look at 5% significance level, at that significance level also we are accepting null hypothesis. If you look at 1% significance level, at that level also we are accepting null hypothesis. So accept null hypothesis. So therefore, the conclusion or interpretation. So what is our interpretation? Here, test statistic value 1.12 is less than critical value. Critical value, I take 5%, 2.28 and 3.169. Therefore, we are accepting null hypothesis. We are accepting null hypothesis at 1% and 5% significance level. Your test statistic is less than critical values, therefore we are accepting null hypothesis at 1% and 5% significance level. And so therefore, hence we are accepting null hypothesis. So what interpretation we can draw? Null hypothesis says there is no significant difference in the mean values, or there is no significant difference in the delivery time of company A and company B. So there is no significant difference in the delivery time of company A and company B. Hence, there is no significant difference. There is no significant difference in delivery time. There is no significant difference in delivery time between two companies. So that is your conclusion for this question. Understood? So as we are accepting null hypothesis, we can say there is no significant difference in mean values. Consider if there is a significant difference. Consider if there is a significant difference in the mean delivery time, then which one you should prefer to buy your product? In which company you are preferred to buy? If there is a significant difference in the delivery time, out of company A and B, which company choose to deliver your product? Just tell me. So in this, here we got there is no significant difference. If there is a significant difference, then which company choose to prefer deliver the product? Can anyone tell me?
Maybe company A.
Company A? Why company A?
The mean value. It is more than The second company.
In the last problem, which is related to, I guess, last one, which is, which one?
Drugs.
Problem related to? I forgot drug. Which one.
Drug one. Production of drugs.
Yeah, yeah. So that is actually effectiveness. Effectiveness means which reduce the weight. So where, weight are reduced more, then it is considered as a more effective. But in delivery time should be minimum, correct? Whenever you order the food, you look at the delivery time. If the delivery time is low, then you go for it. If the delivery time is more, you are not going for it, correct? So here, the average delivery time of company A, it takes 20 minutes. Consider it takes 20 minutes of and 23 seconds. And company B takes 18 minutes and 68 seconds. So out of these two companies, which one you should prefer? Of course, we are going to choose this one. Because it takes minimum time. It takes only 18 minutes, but it takes 20 minutes. So we have to see the nature of the problem. So in the last one is related to reducing weight. So the effectiveness of reducing weight is more when it reduces more weight. But here, suitable company when which delivers the product at lowest time period. If there is a significant difference in the delivery time, then we have to go for company B because it delivers the product at lowest time period. Of course, we have always, when there is a significant difference, we have to see the mean values and we take decisions. Clear? Now, if you have any doubt, you can ask. Any doubt? Okay, tell me your attendance now. Ashok? Bhavyashri?
Present, sir.
Present.
Nanaya?
Present, sir.
Karuna?
Present, sir.
Purnima?
Present, sir.
Rachna?
Present, sir.
Samiksha?
Present, sir.
Okay, thank you. Rashmi present, right?
Present, sir. Okay. Present, sir.
Okay, thank you.